Hi everyone, this is Patty. I've had a lot of you ask how I constructed my loose spine mini. You can see straight through there. You know, it doesn't attach the way it normally does, and it's kind of accordion pleated with no gussets in between. So today I'd like to start a series showing you, here's another one that's a littler one. The pages are just half pages, but again, it's loose and there are no gussets. I want to share, this first video is going to be just the construction of the hinges and how to put your papers on them. So you want to start with a sheet of 12 inch paper. Now I use artisan cardstock because I know I can score on it and fold it multiple times and it's not going to rip. The basis of your book, I don't care what kind of paper you use, but the basis of your book, your spine, your hinges, needs to be something that you have complete confidence in that it's not going to come apart. Because if it comes apart, your whole book is ruined. So make sure that whatever you're purchasing and whatever you're using for your base is a good, solid, constructed cardstock that won't crack, that won't tear, and that will stand up to multiple scorings and turnings and whatever. So you want 12 inches wide, and you're going to cut it the height of whatever your page is. Now on these ones, these were 6x6. The books I'm doing are going to be 5.5 inch square pages. These were even smaller. These were like a 3.5. So you can do whatever floats your boat. You know, your height is your decision. So I'm going to do 5.5 by 12. I'm going to cut my sheet 5.5 by 12 inches. And then it's just a matter of scoring. Let me move the camera in so you get, let me move this over since it's being stinky here, so you get a closer view. Now, if you don't have a scoreboard, you can do it anyway. Grab a ruler and your bone folder and do basically the same thing. A scoreboard is a great tool to add to your arsenal, but if you don't have the funds or you don't have it, you can still make a mini. So I've got 12 inches across. I have 5.5 inches wide. I'm going to score at 1.5 inches. Now, when I first started making this, I was cutting my paper, I think, to like 11 inches and only having 3/4 of an inch at the front and the back. And then I thought, how silly is that? I've got a 12-inch sheet. Let's just utilize the whole thing. And I feel like if you have double the amount to glue to the front of your book and the back of your book, because this is where this little piece will be glued to the front inside cover. It glues right underneath here because this is your spine. If you have twice the amount, an inch and a half, that's much better than 3/4 of an inch. So you're going to just take your 12-inch sheet, you're going to lay it on your scoreboard, and your first score is 1.5 inches. Then you're simply going to count and do every 3/4 of an inch. So it's going to be 2.25. It's going to be 3, 3 3/4, 4 1/2, 5 1/4, 6, 6 3/4, 7 1/2, 8 1/4, 9 3/4. I'm sorry, I wrote that down wrong. This is 9 3/4. 9 3/4 here, and 10 1/2. That will give you 1.5 inches at the back, 1.5 inches at the beginning. And you've got your basis. The next thing you're going to do is you're going to start folding. Your first fold, bring the cardstock up towards you and fold it. The next one, you're going to take the next score mark. You're going to pull it up towards you, create a mountain, and really good crease that, because this is going to be your first hinge for your papers. Then you're going to go to the next one. You're not in, normally in a book, when we do a book like this with hinges, you're going to have a gusset in here, so you can skip one. This book has no gussets, so you're just going to take the next score line, pull it together, crease it. Now we've got two. We're going to fold it. We're going to go to the next one, grab it, score it, fold it till we've done all of them. And then we basically have one, two, three, four, five, get my fingers in here, and six. We have six, see if I can do this here. We have six scored lines. Those are our pages. We have an inch and a half. Well, I needed to grab it right here. Kind of hard here. Inch and a half in the back, inch and a half in the front, and one, two, three, four, five, six pages. Are you with me so far? It's really so super simple, and it makes a great, great book. The next thing, you're going to determine the size of your pages. Now, my pages are 5.5 inches square, so 5.5 by 5.5. If you've decided you want a bigger mini or a smaller mini, cut your pages accordingly, so that they're going to fit. They're going to have to be whatever the height of your spine is, the 5.5 inches. But your width, this way, you can determine whatever you want. Now, in a traditional mini, you would have a gusset and you would glue these two pages together. Do not glue your gussets. They are going to be free, like this one, free. That's what makes this a loose spine mini. You're going to take, I've already done the first one, but let me do one with you. You're going to take your two together, and you're going to take your page, and you're going to glue it right to the hinge part, up to where it folds. See right here in this line? You do not want to go over that fold. That's the key. Because if you do, it's not going to fold, and it's not going to bend, and it's not going to lay flat, and you're not going to want to make it because it's just not going to be constructed correctly. So leave this little bitty, just a fraction of an inch on the other side of that score mark, and glue to this hinge here. And then the back one is going to do the same thing. It's going to glue not only to the back of the hinge, but it's also going to glue to the front page. Now, you have an option. Do you want to have a pocket on the side? Do you want to have a pocket on the top? Or do you not want to have any pockets? My suggestion to you, I like top pockets. So say I'm going to do maybe top pockets. I haven't decided. Leave this free. You can always come back and glue it later. But as you're constructing, you have that option. You'll have an option for a top pocket. So the way you do that, this is glued, and you're going to just glue here, here, and here, three sides, and leave the top free. So let's go back to this front one that I've done, and you can see here that I left the top part free. I glued here, here, and here on the back. And you can also see I left my hinge free. That's going to create your loose spine mini. It's so simple. Just so, so simple. So that's your basic construction. Here you go. So try that, get that far, and I will be doing a whole walkthrough of a whole book showing different ways that I do pages, constructing them. I'm waiting for some paper to come now, and then I will be constructing the whole book. But this gives you the basis of how to construct your hinge portion of the mini. Okay, thanks for joining me, everyone. Have a great crafty day, and I'll see you again real, real soon. Bye.
Hi, everybody. I just wanted to put kind of a side note in here. I do my page and do everything on it, and then I glue it to my hinge. And that's how I'm going to be doing it in the rest of the videos. So if you want to glue all your pages on firsthand and then do the construction on them, that's fine. But I will be doing them as I go along. Okay, see you in the next video.